Hello everyone and welcome to Long's Toys. Today we're taking a look at something a little interesting. This is the Mega Constructs Black series for Game of Thrones. I'm not sure if you're aware, but Mega Constructs recently got the Game of Thrones license, so they've been doing a few Game of Thrones sets. I haven't seen too many. I've seen one set that has the Iron Throne, and then I've seen these cool little dragon eggs. So basically, Daenerys has the three dragons, so there are three different eggs, and this is Drogon. I decided to pick this one up. I just thought he looked the coolest out of the three as far as like the design and the color scheme and everything. And I kind of just wanted to give one of these a shot. These were on sale at Target the other day. I think it was like $8 for one of these. So I'm not sure how big the dragon's going to be once we get him out of there and fully assemble him. I'm trying to figure out how to actually open this thing. It looks like maybe we cut it right here. And then we pull this away. I mean, this obviously... Okay, so that's really it. It's just kind of in there. And then it looks like it has some plastic around the side, which I... Oh, here we go. It's perforated around the back. So this should be a little bit easier to open. There we go. And should be, being the operative term. Okay, well. There we go. Maybe? No? Well, if you stayed with me this whole time while I try to open this plastic egg, thank you. Appreciate it. So you can see it's got kind of a cool cracked line going around the side. So we'll just pull that open. And then, wow, we have a whole Mega Constructs. Wow, these are the wings. These are going to be bigger than I thought. That's actually pretty cool. Wow, this whole thing is going to be a lot bigger than I expected. I thought you'd be able to put it back in the... in the bag when you're or back in the egg when you're done, but I don't think we're going to be able to. Kind of neat how the egg is a different color on the inside. That's pretty cool. All right, I'm going to go ahead and get this built, and then I'll be back and we'll take a look. So I got to say, this is actually really, really cool. It's 100 times bigger than I thought it was going to be. I mean, that's an exaggeration, but I honestly thought when I saw it on the side of the packaging, I thought it was going to be like a small dragon, you know, something like that. But I look on the side of the packaging now, and I realize that it does say 11 inches. So I'm thinking that's the wingspan, because it's pretty huge. Like, that's pretty impressive. And the neat thing about this is that it's kind of a combination of harder and softer plastics. Like, the claws down here are kind of a separate harder plastic piece that pegs into the foot. And the chest here is definitely harder plastic, but then, like, the back and the neck and the head, they're almost like hard plastic with maybe, like, a rubber outer coating or something like that. And then, like, the tail pieces are definitely softer plastic. And then the wings are, like, a really kind of flimsy, almost rubbery plastic. Like, when I first pulled them out of the bag, I thought, oh, no, these are going to be, like, sticky. But they're not. They feel nice. And the cool thing about how these wings work, you can see that you have these long pieces here that fit in with the ball joint. And then they kind of, you know, you stretch these out until they fit over top of them. And then they hook here, and then they hook here. So you have a ball joint here, but you also have two ball joints here. So if you want to kind of bring the wings in or have them kind of like... you know, cover himself up or something like that. Like, I'm not great at posing these, but you could probably do something like that. You don't have to leave them, like, completely flexed out. Like, obviously, if he's flying, you probably want to have them completely flexed out the whole time. But you can kind of bring them in, and he can fold his wings in if you want, which I think is really neat. It's a really smart way of having them articulate. It's a really cool idea. So there's two ball joints here. There's a ball joint here. There's a ball joint where it hits the body, and then there's also a swivel right before that joint here where my finger is. Then you have a ball joint here in the hip. The legs are one solid piece. And then you have a ball joint here, and then you have a ball joint at the base of the neck. Now, I will say there's a few spots like on the hips and the neck, and then there's a ball joint here in the tail, and then this is like a swivel. You could pull this whole piece right off if you wanted to. It just kind of plugs in like that, but otherwise it's a swivel. And there's a few spots like right here. I wish that was a little tighter to the body. It's a little bit farther away. And the neck's not so bad, and the ankles aren't, or the ankles, the hips aren't so bad, especially from different angles. But that tail is, I wish that could go a little bit closer. But these little tuft pieces you can pull out, they're a little bit softer rubber. But yeah, I just think this is really neat. Like I said, it's definitely bigger than I expected. You can see he's got this flame piece. You can take this out if you want. It just plugs into that little spot in the mouth, so if you want to close the mouth up. But I mean, look at that. The eyes look great. I mean, the detailing, the paint all here on the horns on the back of the head look great. And you can open up the mouth. The teeth are painted. I mean, that's awesome. I feel like the mouth on mine is a little slanted, like it's a little off center, but it still looks great. Like I said, I was just kind of blown away because I definitely did not expect it to be this articulated and this big. As you can see, he holds his balance decently when standing like this. If you kind of want him in a more kind of traditional dragon pose, you could kind of put the wings down. If you want to kind of fold them up against the back, you can kind of, oops, I just popped this out of the ball joint. So as you can see, that popped out. You just pop it right back in there like that. No big deal. But I was trying to think if I wanted to kind of have him tuck the wings in. You could do something like this, maybe. Let's see what we can do. Yeah, maybe something like that, and then have him kind of have his wings down like this as he kind of more traditionally moves around when he's not flying. And you can move the tail however you want. I was hoping I'd be able to store him in the egg when I was done because I was expecting him to be much smaller. But I mean, you could definitely take him apart and put him back in the egg if you wanted to. Just pop maybe like the legs and the arms out. You should be able to pull these out not too terribly hard. Let's see if I. Yeah, you can take that out. And then you could store him in the egg, something like that. It just pops right back in there. But just for context, here is. I just happen to have handy like a little halo guy. So this is pretty much the standard size for minifigures for Mega Bloks. Let me see if I can get him to stand. So that's kind of cool if we get this out of the way. I mean, you could definitely have them like ride on the back. So if you got a Daenerys figure, you could definitely have her ride back here. And I think that looks pretty good. I mean, obviously I'd have to mount them better, but just for a quick context, pretty cool. I really like this a lot. I probably won't buy a ton of the like Game of Thrones play sets. I mean, I don't know. Like I said, right now all they have is the Iron Throne, and I'm not super interested in the Iron Throne. Nothing against it. I would go more for like if they had like a big castle play set, or maybe if they had some kind of like battlefield play set, or the ships or something like that, or even like Winterfell, some of the iconic locations from the show, I think would be fun. Like obviously the Iron Throne is iconic from the show, but just to have it by itself, I don't know. Maybe we'll see. Maybe there's a sale or something. But in any case, I think the dragon's really cool. And the other thing that's neat about this dragon, if you have other Mega Constructs properties where a dragon might make sense, like when they did Warcraft or even with Masters of the Universe, something like that, you know, it's just a great little dragon figure. So you could easily just go ahead and use it with some of the other properties. Those two I just named, I think it would work perfectly. They also give you this thing I wanted to show off real quick. You can see you can mount it to the top of the egg. And they show you to take this part off. Like I said, you can see the inside is painted gold. And that's kind of a red into a gold, whereas this is like a red into a black, and it's all black inside. But you can take this little piece. It's just a really simple little square piece that you peg on there, and then you put this piece into the top of it. And that's just really simple. And they have you peg that into one of these spots on his chest, just like that. And then you can simulate the flying of the dragon. Let me move the camera up here. So I think it's pretty cool. I mean, it really is an impressive wingspan when you look at it. They say it's 11 inches. I would not be surprised. I kind of wish the tail... Let me see what I can do with the tail, because I kind of wish that could straighten out a little bit. That's about as much as you can do with it. It's always stuck in this, you know, 90-degree angle here. So I kind of wish they could straighten the tail out. But other than that, I think it's pretty cool. I really was kind of blown away with this. I did not expect it to be this big, and I really did not expect it to be this articulated. I mean, it's nicely painted, nicely detailed. I really, really can't complain. I'm going to go ahead and put the flame back in his mouth because that looks really cool. So, yeah, I like it. Like I said, I think this was either $8 or $9 at Target. I think it was a sale, so they might normally be $10 and it was on sale for $9 or something. You know how Target sales like to pretend like they're really cutting you a break by taking a dollar off. But in any case, I definitely think this would be worth $9 or even $10. I think it's a really nice dragon figure, and I think it would work well with, you know, the Game of Thrones line, Masters of the Universe, even World of Warcraft. Really, really well done. So let me know what you guys think in the comments. Please like, share, comment, subscribe. Hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, thanks so much for watching.